Of course, we have a nice NetLogo model to illustrate our slot machine. This was kindly written for us by our TA, John Ballwit. If I click on Reset, it shows me the slot machine. And we have our three windows with our fruits. And I can set a number of pulls that I want. I'm going to set it to 1 to start off with. And click on Pull Lever N times. The lever's pulled once, we get a new microstate. Pull it again, we get, oh, 3 of a kind there. Very lucky. Okay, so we can set the macro state that we're interested in. I'm going to set it as 3 of the same kind. Okay, and I can ask how many times will I be likely to see that in, say, 1,000 pulls. Well, let's figure that out, and I'm going to do that by writing a note. Okay, so my note is going to say probability of seeing macro state 3 of the same. Well, we said that there were 5 microstates that were included in that macrostate, that is cherry, 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 lemon, 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 etc., etc. And there were 125 possible microstates. So that probability is going to be equal to 5 divided by 125. Put that all on one line. 5 divided by 125, which is equal to 0.04. So that's the probability, if we pull the lever once, that we'll see 3 of the same. It's 4%. Therefore, the expected number of times we'll see our macro state in 1,000 pulls, that's going to be equal to the probability for 1 pull times the number of pulls, which is equal to 40. So let's see how close we are. That's expected. Of course, there's some randomness here. So I'm going to reset and pull the lever 1,000 times. And we can speed it up a little bit, perhaps. We're seeing it slows down a little bit when it gets a jackpot, so we can see the jackpot. But you can see that here's our number of times it's seen the goal macro state, 3 of the same kind, and here's the number of times it's seen the non-macro state. So this is like the win macro state and the lose macro state. And so we're experimentally going to verify our theory, which says that we'll see it about 40 times. Well, 46, of course, if we ran it again and again and again and averaged them all, hopefully they would come out to close to 40. So you'll be able to use this to do some of the homework problems, which involve some other kind of macro states, which we'll look at a little bit later. Now let's bring all this back to our discussion of entropy and statistical mechanics. So remember our NetLogo model, with the two gas model, where we had two rooms, and one room contained the slow particles and the other room contained the fast particles, and then we opened up a gap and they started to mix, so we got this at the start and this at the finish. And we said that the entropy here was lower than the entropy here. That is, by the second law of thermodynamics, entropy increased. Well, in our new language of microstates and macrostates, we can say that the microstate of the system is the position and velocity of every particle. That's kind of like our position and identity of each of the fruits in the slot machine. Here we have one macrostate. All fast particles are on the right, and all slow particles are on the left. And over here, we have another kind of macrostate. Fast and slow particles are completely mixed. Well, if you think about it, our macrostate on the left-hand side corresponds to fewer possible microstates than the macrostate on the right-hand side. That is, there's more ways that different particles could be arranged in terms of position and velocity to create a completely mixed fast and slow particle macrostate Then there are ways in which you could create this more ordered macro state. So here on this side, of course, there's many different ways in which the blue particles could be individually arranged and the red particles could be individually arranged in order for all fast particles to be on the right and all slow particles on the left. It's just that there's fewer such arrangements than there are arrangements in which they're all mixed. So there's many different places this little red particle could be or this little blue particle could be so that these are all mixed, and that's true for all of the different particles. So that is the statistical mechanics notion of higher and lower entropy. And it corresponds very well with our intuitive notions of more disordered and more ordered states. This gives us a new way to state the second law of thermodynamics. First, our original way, we said that in an isolated system, entropy will always increase until it reaches a maximum value. But now we can look at the statistical mechanics version of the second law, which says that in an isolated system, the system will always progress to a macro state that corresponds to the maximum number of microstates. Well, Boltzmann's definition of entropy is conveniently engraved on his tomb in Vienna, so no one ever has to forget it. And his definition says that the entropy S of a macro state is some number K times the natural logarithm, that's this LOG, is the natural logarithm, of the number W of microstates corresponding to that macrostate. Well, K is called Boltzmann's constant. The constant and the logarithm are just for putting the entropy into particular units. So you can really look at this as S equals W. Boltzmann's entropy equals, or is proportional to, in some sense, the number of microstates corresponding to the macrostate. So entropy is a measure of a macrostate, and it measures how many microstates correspond to that macrostate. So the general idea is that the more microstates that give rise to a macrostate, the more probable that macrostate is. So our slot machine, the macrostate of lose was much more probable than the macrostate of win, and we saw that many more microstates corresponded to the lose macrostate than the win macrostate. Intuitively, high entropy just means a more probable macrostate. Or given our gas example, it's much more probable that if the door is open here, the molecules will mix than that they'll just stay or rearrange themselves back into the state in which all the fast ones are on the right and all the slow ones are on the left. It's much more probable that they'll be mixed and be in this state than in this state, so we say that this state has higher entropy than this state. We can now do a final restating of the second law of thermodynamics using our statistical mechanics terminology, and we can say that in an isolated system, the system will tend to progress to the most probable macrostate. Well, this may seem like a tautology, but actually, it's one of the most profound ideas in all of physics, and it gives meaning to the notion of time. You'll find some optional readings suggested on our course materials page that delve much more deeply into this idea than I have time for in this course.